If all of the kings had their queens on the throne, we would say their name and raise a toast. To all of the queens who are fighting alone, baby, you're not dancing on your own.
You can't live without me, you wanna, but you can't, no, no, no.
Think it's funny, but honey, can't run this show on your own. I can feel my body shake, there's only so much I can take. I'll show you how a real queen behaves.
Out there, Lombard staff and students, it's Wellness Wednesday, and it's the perfect day of the week for us to do a little breathing exercise. And I think all of us need to understand that it might seem silly, and I will tell you, I struggle with these, but there is so many benefits and a lot of research that shows that learning how to breathe can really help us handle those big emotions. And I'm seeing that a lot in our building right now. Students are really struggling with emotions and how to handle emotions in a positive and responsible way. And it is so important because it will be a life skill for you to handle, because the adults in front of you right now will tell you those emotions continue. No matter how old you get, you will still experience great emotions and emotions that you wish you didn't experience. But we have to learn how to handle it, because as we continue through life, consequences get harsher, and it is our responsibility to teach you, to train you, to work with you so you learn some appropriate ways to cope with those big emotions. So everyone, we're going to do the tracing hand breathing exercise. So let's take a look, because remember, I am not good at this, so I've got to find someone else to teach it. Let's take a look.
Open up the palm of your left hand and place it on a flat surface. Place the index finger of your right hand and place on the outside of the thumb of the left hand. Now, as you trace the outline of your left hand with the index finger of your hand, breathe in. As you trace and bring your index finger down, exhale out. Keep repeating this process until you have traced the outline of your entire hand. With such calming techniques, you can easily relieve stress or anger that has been bothering you. Make sure that you follow this technique at least 3 times a day and stay calm, as positive energy brings out the best results.
Well, I hope some of you enjoyed that today. And if you didn't and you're like me and you struggle with it, just know that that practicing breathing is just as important as practicing your athletic skills, your academic skills. It is so important for us to recognize that breathing can help us cope with those big emotions. We do have some birthdays to celebrate today, so let's get ready to celebrate our birthdays.
Happy birthday, happy, happy birthday. We celebrate your life today. We're glad that you were born today. What we don't need today, you know what we need today. Happy birthday, happy, happy birthday. We celebrate your life today. We're glad that you were born today. What we don't need today, you know what we need today. Happy birthday, happy, happy birthday. We celebrate your life today. We're glad that you were born today. What we don't need today, you know what we need today. Happy birthday, happy, happy birthday. We celebrate your life today. We're glad that you were born today. What we don't need today, you know what we need today.
Wow, lots of birthdays today. I hope you have a great one. And now let's hear what's on the lunch menu for today.
It's time to get some lunch, lunch. It's time for lunch, lunch. It's time to munch, crunch, eat a bunch. It's time for lunch, not brunch.
I'm starving.
Lunch.
I share the lunch menu. It is National School Breakfast Week. Staff, there are some crossword puzzles, some different activities that are by the mailboxes. If you are interested in using any of those type of items for your classroom, it is, like I said, it is National School Breakfast Week. It is so important for us to eat a healthy breakfast. But on the lunch menu for today, it's a chicken patty We've got diced pears, steamed broccoli, baby carrots, and your choice of white or chocolate milk. And I think all of you know you always have that chef salad choice that always looks delicious. I do want to give a couple shout outs today.
All that shout out loud, stomp your feet to the ground. All that shout out loud, sing a high to the cloud.
Kick off our shout-outs with our winners from our first to submit the answers for our trivia, Mrs. Furrow and Mrs. Jameson's homeroom. So we will make sure you get a prize on Friday. The answers to that trivia, it was how many blackbirds were baked in a pie, 420. How many days old was the peas porridge in a pot? It was 9 days old. And those little kittens lost their mittens. I know I have heard that some students in today's world have kind of forgotten the nursery rhymes, or it's just not taught as often as when some of us grew up. So hopefully some of our students, again, knew those answers. But again, thank you for playing our teamwork trivia. I do want to make sure to give some shout outs to our, they were actually our morning announcement pictures, but yesterday we got to celebrate some ice cream sundae with sprinkles to celebrate the Ryan Crane Sprinkle Kindness Award. And so for those of you that don't know Mr. Ryan Crane, he is an individual I met 2 years ago when I became principal at Lombard Middle School. He just caught my attention because he was constantly bringing, whether it be donuts to my wonderful secretaries, flowers. Sometimes he would just share some type of inspirational message to some of our staff here. He would maybe even bring a pumpkin. And I also started seeing his signature is these lime green shorts, and he would be around town picking up garbage. And so I just noticed he was really trying to do a lot to spread kindness. So I wanted to make sure that we showed him that his kindness was becoming contagious, and he loves like sprinkles. He even wears a little fanny pack that has sprinkles all over it. And so we have been celebrating every month some students that are being caught by staff spreading kindness at Lombard Middle School. Here at Lombard, we feel kindness is just as important as all the other academic and athletic skills. We believe that if you can be a kind student, you can be very successful in the world today. So congratulations to Kingston Kaiser, Julian Henry, Harrison Gibb, Haley Jazek Earl, David Lilo, Jacoby Crooks, and Jonna Lynn Holman. And then, like I said, they got to enjoy some ice cream, and some chose hot fudge, some chose sprinkles, some chose it all. But I wanted to make sure that students know that we are starting to nominate students for March. Those were our February winners. And so at the end of this month, you could be the student who receives either a sprinkle donut or an ice cream sundae with sprinkles. So continue to spread kindness so our building can continue, again, being a great place for all students and staff. And that is it for our announcements. Just a reminder, we have started to kick off our numbers up in our fifth grade. And I know we've got some sixth grade students that are also doing it. Come fourth quarter, we will be doing it school-wide. So just continue again to think about your actions, and also recognize that it's all about our response. So some students are getting more in trouble based on the response and sometimes the first mistake or the first, concern. So please make sure that we are working on spreading that kindness today and following those CHAMP school-wide expectations. I hope everyone has a wonderful Wednesday, and you can end announcements probably for me by now. As always, Zephyrs, go be great.
Today is a new day. Today I promise to work hard, be kind, show pride, and celebrate who I am.
We are Lombard!